We are live now, doctor.
Yeah, thank you. Madam, you have to put your video off. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, dear friends, and a happy Independence Day. Welcome to this mega event, mega quiz, to be done by today, Brain Teaser. It's a special day. Today, Brain Teasers, in association with Delhi Ophthalmological Society, that is DOS, is hosting a mega quiz for you. And this is collaborated and financed by Microvisions. So, small video for you. So it's a play, learn, and fun for you today. Next slide. So with this word, now after the introductory video, I now invite Dr. Namrata Sharma, Secretary, Delhi Ophthalmological Society, as well as Secretary, All India Ophthalmological Society, to introduce to the viewers about the quiz. Dr. Namrata Sharma, madam, please.
Thank you, Dr. Prashant Bhavankule. It is a pleasure here to be introducing this quiz to you. Brain Teasers is a brainchild of Dr. Prashant Bhavankule in association with Numerotech, which is managed by Mr. Sai. And we are happy to collaborate with Brain Teasers and with Dr. Prashant Bhavankule for this quiz. We have close to 1,000 registrations already for the quiz. And the idea of quiz is play, learn, and win. So it is a complete package in itself. This was actually the idea of our president, Professor Subhash Dadia, who is the president of Delhi Ophthalmological Society. He wanted to start the second innings, this new term of Delhi Ophthalmological Society with a mega quiz. And so that is why we thought that, you know, we will start it with a mega quiz. And thanks, Prashant, for again collaborating with us on this. So now I hand over to Professor Subhash Dadia, who is going to say a few words. He's the president of the Delhi Ophthalmological Society.
Welcome, Dr. Subhash Dadia, president, Delhi Ophthalmological Society. Please, a few words for the viewers as well as Delhi Ophthalmological Society members.
Thank you, Dr. Prashant, and thank you, Dr. Namrata Sharma. We are starting our academic program with this mega quiz, and Delhi Ophthalmological Society is known for academic excellence. And I welcome all the delegates for this mega quiz, and I request them to play and win. And Delhi Ophthalmological Society has around 10,000 members and is involved in various academic activities, which will be announced in due course of time. So welcome, everybody.
Thank you, Dadia sir. And this is a brain teaser invite for you people.
It's down, the cursor is a little bit down. You have to move the arrow a little down and here. No, it just came, yes. Here.
So welcome to the season 2 Brain Teasers. I will start sharing my screen in a minute. Dear friends, good afternoon and a happy Independence Day. And once again, welcome to Brain Teasers. Let me introduce you all to the concept of brain teasers. Brain teaser is an edutainment initiative which was introduced last year by Sarakshi Netralaya. In the first season, it was simple online quiz conducted on every Sunday with a weekly and monthly winners. The USP of the quiz was that it had basically clinical scenarios, predominantly based questions. The response and feedback to our tiny effort was phenomenal. Buoyed by the success and feedback from all of you, Brain Teaser was launched in a new avatar in 2020. Brain Teaser is a live online quiz on a web-based platform, which is done on first Sunday of every month. Also, it's no longer just a quiz, but much more. To increase your learning and knowledge, we have added new sections like Pearl of the Month and Wisdom from the Heroes in Ophthalmology. Today's episode, we are coming live on Facebook and YouTube for people who are just interested to watch and learn, but not play or participate. Today, it is a special day for Brain Teasers. It's our proud privilege to associate with one of the largest society, and I'm really thankful to all DAOS executives, president and secretary for this opportunity. Brain Teaser with DAOS has conceived a mega quiz for all of you, and more than 1.2 lakh rupees are at stake today. Also, the winners will get certificates. More importantly, today we have five guests who are stalwarts in the field of ophthalmology and who will be sharing the pearl of the month and the wisdom and the inspiration with us today. I welcome Professor Dr. Atul Kumar Sir, Chief RP Center, New Delhi, Dr. Mahipal Sachdev, President, All India Ophthalmological Society, Professor Ramanjit Sihota, Head, Glaucoma Department, RP Center, Dr. Ashok Grover, Past President, All India Ophthalmological Society, and last but not the least, my dear friend, Dr. Vishal Agrawal from Jaipur. Sincere thanks to each one of you for accepting our invite. No mega event is possible without the generous support of pharma. My heartfelt thanks to Mr. Ashok, Executive Vice President of Micro Labs, for standing rock steadily behind us. Today, my co-hosts are Dr. Namrata Sharma, Secretary AIOS, and Dr. Subhash Dadia, President, Delhi Ophthalmological Society. Welcome, Madam and Sir. Sharing the mantle today, along with me from the house is Dr. Shilpi Narnavre, Chief Coordinator of Brain Teasers. Welcome, Dr. Shilpi. And now I hand over the screen to Dr. Shilpi Narnavre for explaining you the rules of the game. Best of luck.
Good afternoon and happy Independence Day to all of you. Welcome to Brain Teasers. So, are you all excited? Want to win? So, let's understand how to play the game fairly. So, rules for the today's quiz are: who can participate? Yes, any ophthalmologist from a PG to a practitioner, from kids in ophthalmology to the veterans. This session has six sections and every section has five questions. Every question will have four options. Only one amongst them is correct. So you have to select the correct answer and then also press the save button to record your response. After pressing the save button, you cannot change your answer. So don't be in a hurry to press the save button if you are not sure of the correct response. Now, this is what you will see on your screen. This is a sample question for your understanding. Identify the character shown in the picture below. Option A, Tom. Option B, Jerry. Option C, Donald. Option D, none of the above. Now, the timer starts now. This timer will play for 20 seconds. You have to record your response only after the timer starts. If you submit your answer before the timer starts, it will not be recorded. Now here, the answer is B. So first you have to click the option B and then the save button. So who wins the prize? Naturally, the one who answers correct and answers fastest, that is fastest finger first. We don't want seniors and juniors at loggerhead. So we have two categories of prizes. One for the people below the age of 40 years and second for above 40. For every section, we will have one winner. So it means we have six section winners in each category. And that's not all. For the whole session of 30 questions, we have two mega prizes, one for the runner-up and one for winner in both the categories. That means in total, we have 12 section winners, two runner-ups and two winners. Remember, you can be section winner only for one section, but don't give up as you can win the session prize with your consistent performance. What if there is a tie? For tie for a section, the cumulative performance of all the six sections will be considered. But if there is a tie for session, the dice will decide your fate. In case of any discrepancy, the judge's decision will be the binding. Now look, what is at stake today? Amazon gift voucher of rupees 5,000 for every section winner. Runner-up gets a gift voucher worth rupees 10,000. And the winner carries away, wow, 20,000 rupees. That means more than 1 lakh rupees is at stake today. That's not all. Winners will also get the certificate for appreciation. It's not only the gifts. Winners, you will be invited live for the concluding ceremony where you will share the screen and interact with our today's guests who are the who's who in ophthalmology. So winners, be alert. Keep your mobiles ready. You will get a Zoom link as well as a call on your registered mobile number. You will have to join the platform as soon as you get the confirmation. So tighten your seat belts to play the quiz. Now I request Dr. Namrata Sharma ma'am to start the game.
Madam, you have to share.
Yes, I'm sure.
Section one.
Yeah. So
full screen.
So I'm going to be starting section one, which is very interesting. So all of you, please be on your guards. And the first question is this. All of these sports persons are suffering from the same ocular disorder, except Stephen Curry, basketball, Thomas James Pham, baseball, Serena Williams, tennis, Stephen Holcomb, bobsleigh. And your time starts now. So I hope you've all written the answers, submitted your answers, and the answer is can be anybody's guess, but the answer is Serena Williams for tennis. And do you know from what disease are all of them suffering? All except Serena Williams are suffering from no other disease but keratoconus. So all of them are big stalwarts. Stephen Curry in the field of American is an American basketball player. Thomas James Pham, American baseball outfielder for San Diego. Serena Williams, American tennis player. And Stephen Holcomb is an American bobsledder. For the bobsled, he plays for the bobsled event for US. So I'm sure you all must have marked that question correctly, or at least most of you must have marked that question correctly. And the thing would be, who's done it first? Now we come to the second question in this section, which doesn't relate to sports, which doesn't relate to Hollywood or Bollywood, but which relates to cornea. Which one of the following associations is true about corneal collagen components? Type 3 collagen is involved in corneal wound healing. Type 1 collagen is involved with Descemet's membrane. Type 4 collagen is involved with the Bowman's layer. Type 2 collagen is involved with the stroma. And your time starts now. Okay, all of these types are very confusing when they are in the Roman numerals. And the answer is corneal wound healing type 3 collagen is involved. Now you've played, now you have to, it's our duty to make you learn or to make you just mug it up. So this is the way you learn it. Type 1, 1 is always, you know, the winner. So type 1 collagen is most prevalent collagen within the stroma. Type 3, the answer, if you've written correctly, you would know. If you've not written correctly, then also you would know, because we tend to remember what we have done wrong. So type 3 collagen is involved with stromal wound healing. 4, remember the letter 4. 4 is for endothelial cells as well as Descemet's membrane. So this is the posterior most layer of the cornea. So you have type 4 collagen for that. And 1 and 5 is for Bowman's layer. So L is 1 and this W looks like 5. So type 1 and 5 is Bowman's layer. So now, after answering these two questions, we come to the next question. And the next question is as follows. Condition that can give rise to the following appearance include superior limbic keratoconjunctivitis, Sjogren syndrome, Thigason's keratitis, adenoviral keratitis. I think this is one of the easiest questions of this section. And your time starts now. Okay, and the answer is quite simple. The answer is Sjogren syndrome. So the explanation is as follows. You will get this kind of a picture in dry eye as well as in exposure keratitis, and Sjogren syndrome has dry eye. Superior limbic keratitis, as the name suggests, superior limbus would be involved. And in Thigason's and adenoviral keratitis, whole of the cornea is involved. So superior limbic keratoconjunctivitis, only the superior limbus will be involved, so this will be congested. Here, the rose Bengal staining you can see of the dry surface. Thigason's keratitis, you see it in the central pupillary area, and it extends to the entire interior surface of the cornea, and treatment is lubricants and topical steroids. And adenoviral keratoconjunctivitis, you can see that there is a membrane which is present, which covers the inferior tarsus as well as those numeral opacities. Important thing is about the treatment. Sjogren syndrome, you can only give lubricants and punctal occlusion, but topical steroids may have to be started for superior limbic keratoconjunctivitis, Thigason's keratitis, as well as adenoviral keratitis, especially if it is recurrent and involving the pupillary axis or the pupillary zone. Dry eye, you can also start topical steroids provided the cause of the dry eye is inflammation. So after this, we come to the next question. And this is your next question. True statements about ferritin lines include, now there are all ferritin lines, but you have to identify the correct one. Around keratoconus, Fleischer's ring, at the edge of trabeculectomy bleb, Stoker's line, elderly cornea, Henle's line, at the edge of pterygium, Ferry's line. And your time starts now. Thank you. Okay, so the answer is around keratoconus Fleischer's ring. Now, what about all the other rings? Where are they present? So Fleischer's ring is around keratoconus. Stoker's line is around pterygium. Hudson's tally line is seen with aging. Ferry's line is seen after trabeculectomy. So each of these is demonstrated in these pictures. You just have to mug it up. There is no other way out, because sometimes these lines are asked even in your exams. Now, coming to the next question, patient has bilateral poor vision following corneal poor vision and has the following corneal topography. Which statement is not correct? Which statement is false? Inferior thinning of the cornea against the rule astigmatism is common. Iron deposition is seen on the cornea, which is rare. Corneal neovascularization is a common complication. And your time starts now. I think that was a fairly simple one. And the answer is corneal neovascularization is a common complication, is the answer which is for this question. And the idea of this question is not to make you answer right or wrong. The idea is to give you the explanation. So in pellucid marginal degeneration, you have a crab claw pattern, bilateral painless loss of vision, differential diagnosis is keratoconus, and treatment is contact lenses, intact implants, collagen cross-linking, and surgery that we have described, tuck-in lamellar keratoplasty or TILC. And it is important to, while you're here today, see these images once and for all. So this is a normal topography with normal astigmatism, because these two lobes are symmetrical. This is a case of keratoconus. This is pellucid marginal degeneration, which you've answered correctly. And this is keratoglobus. The entire cornea is steep and the entire cornea is thinned out also. Notice that the corneal thickness is less than 300 microns all around, including the periphery. And simultaneously, you can see the AS-OCT pictures, the protrusion of the cornea here. Here, there's thinning. And after this thinning, you would have a corneal thickness, which is normal. And keratoglobus is a globular cornea, which is completely thinned out. So I hope these pictures are ingrained in your minds for you to never forget. Now it is my pleasure and honor to introduce the speaker today. And it is none other than Dr. A.K. Grover. And he actually needs no introduction. He is awarded Padma Shri by the President of India. He's FRCS, he's Chairman of Vision Eye Center, Chairman of Department of Ophthalmology, Sir Gangaram Hospital, New Delhi, President of South Asian Association of Oculoplastic Reconstructive and Oculofacial Aesthetic Surgery, past President of Asia Pacific of Oculoplastic and Reconstructive Surgery, past President of All India Ophthalmological Society and Oculoplastic Association of India. He's been very actively involved with the ophthalmic education in our country and also abroad. He's very closely linked to International Council of Ophthalmology, where he's in their examination committee. And he's going to be talking to us about choice of career for a postgraduate in ophthalmology. So this is his presentation now.
Good morning. Today, we are going to discuss with you a career in ophthalmology. Let us begin by checking out why a young intern would choose ophthalmology as a career, and let's see whether it matches your person. This was a survey that was carried out amongst interns in Andhra Pradesh, and the graduates of medicine or the interns felt that the reason why they would take up ophthalmology was that it was a prestigious specialty. This was the feeling of 71% of them. And 67% of them felt that it is a rewarding specialty. And a large number of them wanted to take it up for the reason that it has a good earning potential. Well, does your perception agree with it, or have you realized that medicine may be a very noble profession, but it's not a great business? So I hope you are not saying, oh God, what have I gotten myself into? But now that you are stuck, it's better. Good morning. Today, we are going to discuss with you a career in ophthalmology. Let us begin by checking out why a young intern would choose ophthalmology as a career, and let's see whether it matches your perception. This was a survey that was carried out amongst interns in Andhra Pradesh, and the graduates of medicine, or the interns, felt that the reason why they would take up ophthalmology was that it was a prestigious specialty. This was the feeling of 71% of them. And 67% of them felt that it is a rewarding specialty. And a large number of them wanted to take it up for the reason that it has a good earning potential. Well, does your perception agree with it, or have you realized that medicine may be a very noble profession, but it's not a great business? So I hope you are not saying, oh God, what have I gotten myself into? But now that you are stuck, it's better that you make the best out of it. But jokes apart, ophthalmology is certainly a great choice as a career, for several reasons. The joy of giving, the joy of being able to serve the underserved, is the most important of them. Of course, there are several other rewards professionally, career-wise, financially, and for the recognition that one gets. So let's get on to the job of looking at the choices that you have for your career in ophthalmology once you have completed your post-graduation. So let's look at or a laid back and a relaxed person. So this is one very important aspect in your choice of career goals. Before we go on to the options, let's talk about what factors influence the decision that some of you make. It's a combination of four factors. What with your background and with your training you are eligible for, what are the choices available to you, and what is available to you at that moment, and what is most feasible to you. So these combination of factors often help determine your choice of career. Let's look at the one of the factors which is important is the academy. Family background, often this will make a difference whether you have a medical background or not, and what is the financial status of the family to be able to support a particular kind of career. If a medical background, what is the kind of medical family background? Do you have the backing of an establishment, or is your Are your parents in a government job or in a teaching job? So this will determine your choices. Financial issues, of course, are important. Do you have the financial resources and the place to begin work on your own if you choose to do so? This again is an important part. And the family influences. Divide the short-term training options into senior residency, which may be in private institutions or in government institutions, the various fellowships that you know in subspecialties, working with charitable institutions, and the various options abroad, which largely remain confined to United Kingdom, US, New Zealand, Australia. Other choices like the Middle East have generally. If your goal is to prepare a base for later practice in the area or to develop more hands-on experience rather than going into a subspecialty. So charitable institutions would then be the right grounding. Those of you who would be interested in training abroad or working abroad, then the various options of international fellowships or international work come in. Now, in the UK, you need to clear PLAB. The options may improve now that the UK is out of Euro, and therefore the options may open up more for those from the subcontinent. You also have the option of doing FRCS while you are in India, which would open up some choices for you in Middle East, in Singapore, in Australia. You may have a greater maneuverability. In the US, you need to, if you want to do a post-graduation, you need to clear your basic certification for eligibility to enter a residency program, and it may be multi-stage, and this is best done at the stage before you've done your post-graduation. But after your post-graduation, the road may be more difficult. You may again need to do a residency, or you may need to go as observer or a fellow in some of the institutions, and there, from there, depend on good references to take you further in your life. In US, you have a number of international ophthalmology fellowships, some with research and clinical responsibilities as well, but the license becomes important. So only in some states can you go in and do clinical work. So these are the various options available to you for the short term and the long term. But let's conclude by looking at some tips offered in decision making by Jim Rianzo. Get to know yourself. Decide what would make you most happy, and that is what decides what you want. Make sure that whatever resources you have are best utilized. And the most important among the resources is your contacts with people. Nurture them, look after them, maintain them. And always be flexible, both personally and professionally. Keep your options wide open. Explore all of them. Don't close any doors. Create a 5-year window. Decide where you want to be in 5 years. And plan accordingly.
So now we will announce the. Am I unmuted? Can somebody unmute me?
No, we can hear you.
Okay. So now is the time to announce the winners of section one. And it is my pleasure to announce that in the age group more than 40 years, Dr. Guru Murthy from Prodatur is the winner of section one. And in the age group less than 40 years, Dr. Sivagami N. from Puducherry is the winner. With this, I hand over for the next section to Dr. Subhash Dadia.
Madam, you stop sharing.
I have stopped sharing.
Yeah. So very good afternoon and welcome to section 2. So following celebrities, they suffer are suffering from a common ocular disorder, except your choices are option A, Russell Crowe, Ryan Gosling, Scarlett Johansson, and D, Paris Hilton. Your time starts now. And the correct answer is option C, Scarlett Johansson. Most effective concentration of atropine to delay progression of myopia as per recommendation of LAMP study is? Your options are A, 0.25%, option B, 0.05%, option C, 0.1%, and option D, 0.5%. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is option B, 0.05%. LAMP study was conducted to evaluate efficacy and safety of low concentration atropine of 0.5%, 0.025%, and 0.1%, and it was compared with placebo over a period of 1 year, and 0.05% was most effective in controlling progression of myopia and axial length elongation. In ATOM 2 study, atropine 0.01% was found to be as effective as other concentrations with minimal side effects. We have also similar experience. Next question is, all are true about acute acquired concomitant esotropia except option A, there is sudden onset of diplopia. Option B, there is presence of large angle esotropia. Option C, it is typically seen in children below age of 2 years. And option D, exact etiology is not clear. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is C. Acute onset esotropia is commonly seen in older children. Hyperopia is uncommon neurological evaluation, and MRI should be done to rule out Arnold-Chiari malformation, and surgery is done to maintain binocular vision, and it is of 3 varieties. Next question is, Harada-Itoh procedure is used to treat cases of, options are option A, third nerve palsy, cases of congenital fourth nerve palsy, option C, cases of acquired fourth nerve palsy, and option D, cases of congenital sixth nerve palsy. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is option C. Harada-Itoh procedure is used in cases of acquired fourth nerve palsy. Basically, in Harada, it is procedures, superior oblique tendon is split and anterior fibers, which are responsible for encyclotorsion, are moved anteriorly and laterally, and this enhances encyclotorsion power of the superior oblique. And in these cases, there is diplopia with extorted images. Other procedures for fourth nerve palsy are inferior oblique recession, inferior oblique weakening, SR recession, IR recession, and SO tuck. And the next question is, typical features of Brown plus syndrome includes option A, Brown syndrome plus inferior oblique overaction, option B, Brown syndrome plus superior oblique overaction, option C, Brown syndrome and Duane's retraction syndrome, option D, Brown syndrome with chronic progressive external ophthalmoplegia. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is option B, Brown syndrome plus superior oblique overaction. Basically, Brown syndrome is because of tight superior oblique muscle. Brown plus is superior oblique overaction with hypertropia. Acquired cases of Brown may be due to post-surgery, trauma, sinus infections, and inflammatory disease. And treatment, in some cases, it resolves spontaneously, topical steroids and surgery. And in congenital Brown syndrome, the choice is surgery. Now, it is my proud privilege to introduce Padam Shri Professor Atul Kumar Sir. Professor Atul Kumar Sir is Chief of RP Center AIIMS, New Delhi. He is advisor to Government of India in ophthalmology and armed forces as well. He was awarded Padam Shri by President of India. It is fourth highest civilian award in India given for services in medicine. He has also been conferred B.C. Rai National Award for his excellence in the field of medicine in the category of eminent medical teachers. University Grant Commission recognized his scientific work by giving him Hari Om Ashram Trust Award for role as outstanding social scientist for interaction between science and society. Sir is a fellow of National Academy of Medical Sciences since 2006. The alumni body of his school too has facilitated him very recently. He has also been awarded Fellowship of Royal College of Surgeons, Edinburgh, FRCS, for his furtherance and excellence in vitreoretinal surgical techniques. During his tenure, RP Center has reached to unparalleled heights and it continues to flourish under his umbrella of his leadership. He is one of the doyens in vitreoretina.
Sir, and for the sake of viewers, because of some unavoidable circumstances, Professor Atul Kumar had to leave the meeting. Some emergency work has crept up. And so he wanted to address the viewers, young viewers, especially people who are going to play the quiz. We are really sorry because he had some emergency work. Yeah.
So he may join later on, so we'll announce the winner.
No, before that, we have Daria sir. Can you stop sharing your screen? I will play till we compute the results. We have some pleasant duties to do. We have some. Yeah, please. We need to thank the people who have been behind us. Yes. Okay. 1 minute. So, see, as I said initially in my introductory talk, that nothing is possible, especially if more than 1.2 lakh rupees at stake with all this mega platform for brain teasers and getting all the people together. A lot of hard work has gone and the back work is done by the micro lab people. We are really thankful and indebted to them. This is a small commercial break till we compute our results. Thank you, MicroLab, for wonderful support you have been giving us. And till our results are out, this is one of our videos to be played. So remember, viewers, Brain Teaser is just not a single quiz. Remember, we need to play every month, once the first Sunday of every month, this quiz is being done. Do remember this video and encourage other your postgraduates to participate in it. It's not just an education, but also an entertainment. Thank you, sir. Now you can announce the winners.
So the winners in the category below 40 years are Dr. Maria, doctor from Hyderabad, and in category of above 40, Dr. Rupa, MS from Mumbai. Congratulations to the winners.
Congratulations to the winner. And here we move to the next section, that is section 3. So, yes, everyone knows John Goodman. Yes, he's an Academy winning actor who played a famous role of Balu in Jungle Book. And yes, option B seems to be Lawrence Zigger, a famous host of TV epic show, that is Larry King Show. And of course, option C, that is Yash Gera and Shah Rukh Khan, are our own people. Everyone knows them. So most of you might have identified them right. But the question is about them is, all famous personalities underwent similar ocular surgery except one. So you have to identify the odd man out. And here is the time. So how many people answered it correct? Yes, the odd man out over here is Shah Rukh Khan, correct? And what is the difference? All the rest except Shah Rukh Khan underwent cataract surgery, while this gentleman, the superstar of our Bollywood, has undergone a presbyopia surgery. Okay. So now let us move to the more tougher questions. Enough of fun. We all know that various systemic disorders can affect the eye. These are the systemic disorders which are associated with typical morphological types of cataract. So your question is, of the four, which association amongst them is wrong? So your time starts now. Yeah, so it's Alport syndrome. Yeah, it causes anterior lenticonus, not posterior lenticonus. And so these are the various types of cataract you can see over here. This is a classic sunflower cataract, which we see in a Wilson's disease. Important other clinical sign which is seen is a KF ring, which you see on the cornea. While in myotonic dystrophy, you see this classic Christmas tree cataract. Alport syndrome, as I said, it causes anterior lenticonus, which is classically described as a oil droplet sign. While this particular variant has a cerulean cataract, or otherwise also known as blue dot cataract. So I hope most of you must have answered it right. Now let's move to the next question, that is MCQ number 3 or 13. With regards to the materials used in the intraocular lens, all is true except option A, PMMA, is the most common material used in foldable lens. Option B, PMMA transmits a broader spectrum of light than the natural lens. Option C, silicon material is associated with increased capsular fibrosis. And option D, leads to silicon oil bubble adhesion if used in retinal detachment surgery. So all is true except one option. Time starts now. And the correct answer is PMMA, most common material used in foldable lens. No, PMMA is used to create a hard type of a lens or a rigid type of a lens, and it is hydrophobic. And thus, regarding the two sentences about silicone lenses is true, it is hydrophobic, but silicone oil causes adhesion to it. So in a vitreous surgery, wherever a silicone oil is needed, it can be a problem. And also it is known for increased capsular fibrosis and thereby fibrotic type of posterior capsular opacification. And so is not a preferred lens, especially in a high myope or eyes which are likely to undergo a vitreous procedure. Now moving on to next question, that is MCQ number 14. Histological features of following are true except option A, Elchnik pulse. It is a proliferation of lens epithelium onto the posterior capsule. Option B, posterior subcapsular cataract is caused by bladder cells. Option C, glaucoma flaccum happens because of Weddell cells. Option D, Sommerin ring is because of sequestration of proliferating lens fibers in equatorial region of capsule. And your time starts now. Only one of the sentence is option is wrong. Rest three are right. I think probably this was the easiest of the questions, I believe, in this series, besides the Hollywood one. Yes, option C, glaucoma flaccum is caused by Weddell cell, is wrong. Remember, bladder cells or Weddell cells are responsible for subcapsular cataracts, and they migrate posteriorly to posterior capsule, while glaucoma flaccum is caused because of necrotic lens epithelial cells and degenerated subepithelial cells. And when does it happen? When there is a accelerated rise of intraocular pressure. And you can see something like this. That is a classic glaucoma flaccum that is happening because of transient sudden rise of intraocular pressure. While Sommerin ring is because of the adhesion of anterior posterior capsule leading to proliferation in that space. While Elchnik's pulse, which is classically seen like bubbles on a retroillumination, is because of posterior migration of cluster of LECs. Now let's move to the next question. That is the last question of this section. This is an image-based question. Yes, this is a subluxated crystalline lens superiorly. Which systemic disease is not associated with this type of condition? So you have option A, option B, option C, option D. So which of this systemic association is not associated with subluxated anterior, subluxated superiorly cataract? Now, so how many of you guessed right? Yes, the option B is wrong. Why? Let's understand. The subluxation classically superior means Marfan syndrome, and the mnemonic of Marfan syndrome is mitral wall prolapse, that is MA is aortic dissection. R stands for retinal detachment, F stands for fibrillin 1 mutation, A stands for arachnodactyly, N stands for nearsightedness and scoliosis. So the picture which was shown was of a normal heart, normal aorta, while Marfan's syndrome is associated with aortic dissection. So let's move to the next part. That is, we have completed the section three, so we need a break. So let's have something from one of the heroes of ophthalmology. And today, it's my proud privilege to welcome my dear friend, Dr. Vishal Agrawal. Vishal Agrawal has done his MD from RP Center, Delhi, his fellowship from Shankar Netralaya, Chennai. He has given me a short bio data, but I would just speak few words why he was invited amongst the tallest people in today's episode, like Dr. Atul Kumar, Ashok Grover sir, Ramanjit Siota madam. Why? This man at this young age has multiple awards, and he has an addiction, rather he has developed an addiction to winning the video awards. He started with best video awards at Jaipur, then he graduated to Rajasthan Ophthalmic Society, multiple awards. Then he got C.S. Reshmi Video Award, one of the highest awards in All India Ophthalmological Society. And he's no longer just quenched with having acquired so many videos, so many awards. And now he is aiming, and rather he has already to his kitty added best video prize in Euretina Copenhagen, that is 2016. Then he also got Red Buckler Best Video Award at ASRS, that is American Society of Retina Specialists, in 2020. He got Image of the Year from again from American Society of Retina Specialists in 2019, and in Euretina Best Video Prize Copenhagen again in 2016. So this man is really greedy for various awards, video awards. And let us understand from him, why, how does he make an award-winning video? So let's understand from him.
Making of an award-winning video is an art beyond your skill set of performing wonderful surgeries. I share to you my 10 commandments, which make this task less confusing and more streamlined for all of you. Number one, don't be in a hurry. Precise surgical video recording requires a lot of checks and rechecks. The surgery is more important than its display to an audience, so new surgeons should take it easy. Number two, spend in the right kind of medical grade equipment, which can be harsh to your pocket initially, but in the long run, the dividends are worth it with minimal running cost. Number three, know your basic recording physics, that is white balance, ISO, Kelvin readings, dynamic brightness, to name a few, because the video is as good as you fiddle with the settings more frequently. For example, low Kelvin temperature is required for interior segment recording, and a higher temperature is required in low light settings, such as VR surgeries. Also, knowing how much light your beam splitter is throwing to your recording device is important to adjust dynamic brightness, like in these two cases of ONH pit with different beam splitters. Point number four, content is the king. In the end, judges who are evaluating are impressed by the core content of the video, no matter how fancy your submission is. Routine cases generally do not create an impact. Rare cases, case series, new innovations, and complications with their management will definitely up your game. Adding special effects. It always helps to add animations and illustrations to convey the message. Relevant film clips can also be added.
And my father's father and my weird Aunt Chloe have all searched for the eggs, but only I, King Mudbeard, have found them. I present to you the eggs.
Point number six, don't overdo it. All the add-on accessories like animation and special effects should not overshadow the main content. It is like sitting in a joint with loud music. You actually don't have any real conversation. Point number seven, a good voiceover. The tips for it are to have the right mic, to record in a quiet place like a studio, to rehearse properly with making notes. Well, for me, a quiet room with a blanket over my head works better than a studio. Point number eight, never shy away to record your mistakes. Showing surgical complications and their management definitely puts the submission right at the top. Point number nine, know your platform. Read carefully the different submission guidelines, which may vary from conference to conference. And the last point, keep the Josh high. Even your best videos might not win, but then that is bad luck. Keep trying, make good videos, and you will be at the podium one day. Thank you. Making of an award.
So, everyone is excited to know the Section 3 winners? Yes, here it is. Dr. Shrikant Kumar Padhi from Bhubaneswar in the category of less than 40 years. And Dr. Santosh Kumar from Delhi in the category of more than 40 years. Congratulations, winner. Keep on playing. We have session winner, session prizes to win further. So over to Dr. Namrata Sharma for her, I'm stopping my screen share for the next section.
Okay, we come to section 4. So you are back with me again. And Shrikant Padhi and Dr. Santosh Kumar are both, I think, from RP Center, and congratulations to them. So come to section 4. And it, just because I'm doing the quiz, it doesn't mean that it is going to be related to my specialty. It can be just anything. So keep your eyes and your ears open. So what is so peculiar about Hillary glasses? She's a spy. She has spy glasses with camera. These are Google glasses. They are prisms or they are AFK glasses. And your time starts now. And of course, the answer is prisms. So she wears prisms. And why does she wear prisms? She wears prisms because she has double vision after a fall-induced concussion in 2012. And these are Fresnel's prism, which is an adhesive version of prism. So now we come to the next question. And the next question is as follows. When a tight suture is placed radially in the cornea, the following may occur. The cornea adjacent to it is flattened. The curvature of cornea along that meridian is increased. The curvature of cornea at 90 degrees to that meridian is decreased. All of the above. And your time starts now. Okay, so that was a very basic question. I think almost all of you would have got this correct. And the answer is all of the above. The explanation is that the tight suture flattens the cornea adjacent to it, but increases corneal curvature along that meridian. And the curvature of the cornea at 90 degrees from it is decreased due to coupling. And deep suture and the one nearer to the center of the cornea has more effect on the corneal curvature. So next, let's come to the next question. And the next question is this. Following are true about intracorneal, intratromal corneal ring segments, except they are used to treat myopia. They are made of PMMA. It's a reversible procedure and it uses a keratome. And your time starts now. So the answer is it uses a keratome. So intracorneal ring segments, they do flatten the cornea. They are used to treat myopia. They are used to treat keratoconus. It is made of PMMA. You have a pocketing hook and a symmetric glide, which is used to make it. Alternatively, even femtosecond has been used to make those channels. and they are reversible. So if there's a problem, you can always remove them. The problem only is that they have fluctuating vision. Patients may have for weeks to months. We come to the next question, and the next question is as follows. What is true about femtosecond laser? Again, this is a very basic question. Low pulse energy, high pulse frequency, high pulse energy, low pulse frequency, high pulse energy, high pulse frequency, and low pulse energy with low pulse frequency. And your time starts now. Okay, and the answer to that question is very logical. Low pulse energy and high pulse frequency. And why does that occur? That occurs because you don't want any collateral damage to occur. So femtosecond laser, the wavelength is 1053 nanometers. The pulse duration is 10 raised to the power minus 15 seconds. High frequency allows reduced flap creation time, and low energy per pulse leads to smoother corneal stromal bed, and that is why the answer. So if you just look at the spot size, this is how the spot separation is. So cutting process is driven by these mechanical forces of bubbles. So you need high pulse energy and low pulse frequency. Whereas if you look at femtosecond LASIK, the cutting process is limited by focal spot size. So you need low pulse energy and high pulse frequency. So the next question is, all are true about astigmatic keratotomy except incision is placed perpendicular to the steepest meridian. It has a coupling effect. Nearer the incision to the center, greater the reduction of astigmatism. The site of incision should be based only on corneal topography in phakic patients. And your time starts now. Okay, so I think that was an easy one because this question is only by exclusion, and exclusion questions are always very easy. So the answer is very logical. The site of incision should be based only on corneal topography in phakic patients is wrong. Why? Because when you do a refraction, you have to calculate the total astigmatism. The astigmatism in phakic eye is due to two reasons, corneal as well as lenticular. So the corneal topography measures only the corneal astigmatism and not the lenticular astigmatism. Now, incision, which is closer to the central zone, obviously would have a greater effect. Coupling effect is always present when you do astigmatic keratotomy. In fact, when you do any corneal procedure, and of course, it should be perpendicular to the steepest meridian. So this part of the section is over, and it is my pleasant duty to introduce my role model, my mentor, my teacher from RP Center for Ophthalmic Sciences, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Professor Ramanjeet Sihota. She completely needs no introduction. When I joined undergraduation in Lady Harding Medical College, and when I was in third year, I saw her join as assistant professor in the ophthalmology department, and she taught us glaucoma. And at that time only I decided that I wanted to become like her. I wanted to be something like her. And that is why I'm saying that she has been my role model ever since my MBBS days. Professor Ramanjeet Sihota did her FRCS and FRC Oft and is heading the glaucoma research facility and clinical services of RP Center. She completed her MD ophthalmology in 1982. She's FRCS Edinburgh way back in 1984 when nobody used to do FRCS. She has won the World Glaucoma Association Research Recognition Award in 2011. She has numerous national and international awards. The list is actually endless, but very importantly, she has done work related to glaucoma in India, and that is a landmark work which has been done by her and her team, which is related to primary angle closure glaucoma, glaucoma surgery, and imaging in glaucoma. She is a member of International Glaucoma Research Society, National Task Force on Glaucoma, the Glaucoma Advisory Board, Project Evaluation Committee of ICMR, DST, DBT. She's also been the executive committee member of Asia Pacific Glaucoma Society, Glaucoma Research Society, and she's been on the committees of several committees of the World Glaucoma Association. And I think we all know her. Each one of us who has been through MBBS knows her because we all read her book, Parsons Disease of the Eye, in which she has written the Indian edition and has written several chapters in the books. Besides this, she has landmark papers to her credit, more than 200 international indexed peer-reviewed publications, which have changed the way we practice glaucoma. And I think she is going to be talking on a very, very apt topic for her, and that is what I have learned and taught in the last 30 years in glaucoma.
I was lucky enough to have good mentors. I've been lucky enough to have good colleagues, good juniors, and I think all of them have taught me that we need to do a detailed clinical examination before taking the help of any technology. I have also been taught to ask questions: what, why, when, how, to treat patients as I would like to be treated. That has helped us to ask the question, why did patients progress when we lowered the IOP to so-called normal at 21 millimeters of mercury? And over the next 5-10 years, we looked at hundreds of patients and realized that 21 millimeters of mercury was absolutely not a clinical feature at all. And we should be looking at much lower pressures. The more advanced the glaucoma, the lower the target IOP. When I joined ophthalmology, primary angle closure glaucoma was only thought to consist of an acute angle closure, and it was thought to be very rare. However, when we did our clinical examination carefully, we found that it was a common disease. We were able to figure out characteristic changes in these patients. We were able to understand the pathogenesis with EM, light microscopy. We were able to show that in the classification that was suggested of suspect, primary angle closure and primary angle closure glaucoma, there was a vital part that was missing, that was primary angle closure in whom the IOP was high, because if you treated these patients, they never developed neuropathy and they could never develop any blindness. We were also able to show over 10 years that if a baseline IOP was less than 30, they would do well with medications over this period. If they had a baseline IOP of more than 30, the bugbear of 21 milliliters of mercury also stretched into treating childhood glaucomas, and we would find 4 or 5 years later a lot of children would come to us with high myopia, with retinal detachments. And then we sort of asked ourselves, what is the normal IOP in children? When we looked at 700 and 800 children, we were able to see normal IOP was only 10 or 12 millimeters, and therefore we lowered the IOP to less than 15, and we kept in mind that these children are going to live for the next 50 years and would therefore require low IOPs to, even if they come at with an eye that looks like this, we are able to achieve clearing, to achieve a good prognosis with. Having said low IOPs, question is, how are we going to achieve these low IOPs, and therefore we need successful surgeries. When mitomycin arrived, we were very happy, but what we did find 4 or 5 years later is that it can produce a sweating or a dysesthetic phlegm. So the first thing to do is to use low doses for a short duration, and when you do find this, when we did look at these blebs with an EM, we found that the only thing wrong was that there was a thinning or break of the basement membrane, and therefore we devised this surgery for bleb revision, in which you can just remove this epithelium and you leave a functioning bleb and the IOP is controlled. So I hope if you ask questions, you can get answers which help you, will help your patients. But I think at the end of the day, we have to have many other interests besides ophthalmology. You must enjoy life. When you do that, it makes you think out of the box. It recharges your batteries. And I hope that you come back revitalized and treat your patients with care. Thank you.
So that was a very inspiring talk by Professor Amanjeet Sehota. She plays cricket, she plays lawn tennis, she plays badminton. So I know her other side of extracurricular activities also besides ophthalmology. And now it is time to announce the winners of Section 4. And I am happy to share that both of them I know very well. So more than 40 years, it is none other than Dr. Pranav Ranjan from Patna. And less than 40 years, it is Dr. Rinki Aha from Kolkata. Congratulations, winner. And now we move on to the next section.
So welcome to Section 5. The question is, all of them suffered from one single disorder except, and choices are option A, Kasto Mukherjee, option B, Angela Jolie, option C, Sylvester Stallone, and option D, Anupam Kher. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is option A, Kasto Mukherjee. Except Kasto Mukherjee, all had facial palsy at one point of time. Next question is, all is true about Horner syndrome except option A, anisocoria accentuated in dim light. Option B, it is preganglionic type lesion. Option C, 1% apraclonidine dilates pupil. And option D, 1% phenylephrine dilates the pupil. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is option C, 1% apraclonidine dilates normal pupil. All is true about intranuclear ophthalmoplegia, INO. Option A, it is caused by lesion in PPRF. Option B, diplopia is uncommon complaint in unilateral INO. Option C, defective abduction on the side of lesion and nystagmus of contralateral eye on adduction and gaze to side of lesion is normal. And your time starts now. And correct answer is gaze on the side of the lesion is normal. Basically, intranuclear ophthalmoplegia is due to damage to interneurons, that is MLF, between two nuclei of the cranial nerve, that is 6th and 3rd. And there is ipsilateral adduction deficit with contralateral nystagmus on abduction and horizontal gaze towards the affected side is normal. And if there is lesion in PPRF, it causes horizontal gaze paresis and 1.5 syndrome. All are the features of Perrineaud syndrome except Option A, supranuclear upgaze. B, defective convergence. Option C, small pupil with near light dissociation. And option D, dorsal midbrain syndrome. And your time starts now. And the correct answer is option C, small pupil with light near dissociation. Basically, in perinoid syndrome, there is lesion in the dorsal midbrain. There is upgaze palsy. There is convergence, retraction, nystagmus. Causes may be pineal lesion, tumors, brainstem hemorrhage, and ischemic infarcts. And clinical symptoms include diplopia, blurry vision, oscillopsia, light near dissociation, Collier signs, other signs, ataxia, exotropia, convergence insufficiency, and papilledema. Next question is, what is Anton syndrome? Option A, formed visual hallucination. Option B, visual variations of Alzheimer's disease. Option C, denial of blindness. And option D is optical ataxia and ocular apraxia. And your time starts now. And correct answer is option C, that is denial of blindness. In Anton syndrome, there is bilateral occipital lobe damage, cortically blind patients, elderly with multiple vascular risk factors. There are formed visual hallucinations, clear lifelike images such as faces of animals or people, schizophrenia, and schizophrenic affective disorders. Now it is my proud privilege to introduce Padam Shri Dr. Professor Mahipal Singh Sachdev. Dr. Mahipal Singh Sachdev requires no introduction. He is currently president of All India Ophthalmological Society and director Center for Sight Group of Eye Hospitals. He has been chairman scientific committee All India Ophthalmological Society. He has been president secretary Delhi Ophthalmological Society. He is currently also chairman IIRSI. He has numerous awards to his credit. He is one of the pioneers and doyens in cataract and refractive surgery.
Thank you very much, Dr. Subhash. Being a pleasure being with all of you, and specifically with DOS, because this is one of the organizations that I have seen grow from strength to strength, that I think it is one of the leading organizations today after All India Ophthalmological Society in sheer numbers, as also the quality of work that is being done. Always a pleasure to be of help and be associated with DOS. And thank you very much for asking me to talk about entrepreneurship and how we can adapt ourselves in this COVID-19 situation. Thank you.
Welcome, Dadi. Welcome, Mahipal sir. It's a privilege and it's a pride to us that you have attended our small program on Brain Teasers. It's really a matter of honor to us as a Brain Teaser group.
Welcome, sir.
Dadi, sir, you can play the video.
Welcome, sir, and thank you. Thank you so much for sparing your time. We know that you are in three other webinars.
No worries.
Thank you.
Dadi, sir, you have to play sir's video from your screen. Yeah, play it.
I think the audio is not coming.
Sir, you can stop sharing. I can help you out. Nadia, sir, you stop sharing. I would help you out. 1 minute. Yeah, here is Dr. Mahipal Sajdev.
Dear friends, good evening. I have been asked to talk about what is the present situation as to how it is posing challenges to all of us as ophthalmologists and what, according to me, would be the mantra for success. Now, entrepreneurship is something that one has to develop over time as to the mindset that you have to create something, to leave behind an institution or to leave behind a legacy. Now, what is important is that the COVID-19 epidemic has hit us like a storm. None of us ever thought that this would happen. But what is important for us is not to go into a shell, but to actually look intelligently and try and be able to adapt to this new normal that is happening, the changes that the COVID-19 has been brought about in the lives of everybody. So I think if your intelligence is going to count, it is going to be the ability to adapt to this change that has happened. And as we all know, the Charles Darwin, as he said, it is not the strongest of the species that survive, nor the most intelligent. It is the one that is most adaptable to change. I think in no other time than this time have we to change, to adapt. We have to be adaptable, moldable. We have to be like a liquid. We have to be like water. And we don't need to be a person who is going to be like a solid, not willing to change at all. Because there has been a tectonic shift, a millennial shift as to what is going to happen, what is going to stay, and what is going to succeed or not succeed. If we get steadfast, stuck into what we were before COVID, we will not be able to progress. I think there is no other time than now to change. There were several things which were right or wrong within organizations. I think this is the best time for us to relook, to reassess, and to reconfigure. I think we have to reconfigure and we have to realign our strengths. That is something very, very important that one needs to do. I think what is going to happen post-COVID is that there is going to be a certain amount of consolidation that's going to happen. As and when there is a storm, there are weak trees which will fall, and there will be very, very strong trees which can also break. So people who are going to be flexible and people who are going to be able to adapt, their businesses or their organizations are the ones that are going to happen to be the successful ones. Now, what is very, very important is that apart from a macro consolidation, there has to be a micro level consolidation. That means that within your organization, you need to consolidate on your strengths. What are your strengths? Do an in-depth analysis and see what are your weaknesses. I think this is the time when you can take actions which are going to shed the dead wood out of organizations. You need to look at reinventing yourself, reinventing your organization into a new normal that is going to be there. Now, just let us look at an example. For example, in Delhi, there are plastic machines which are there. And it was competition which was there, which was making us try to run faster than each other. And I think this was something which was a self-defeating thing. What COVID has taught us is that if we collaborate, you can see that, for example, the development of a vaccine, it is not an individual effort, but it is a global effort between different companies, different countries, different scientists, everybody collaborating, and that is going to have a vaccine sooner than later. So it is very, very important that we shed the competition, which is what we were trying to make faster growth. It is a sense of collaboration that we should have. Ultimately, if we collaborate among ourselves, I think we will cut the losses that all of us are facing in the businesses, which are going to cause us problems. What is important is that once we start to collaborate, this should be just the beginning of a process. And if we start to work together as ophthalmologists or as groups or as chains, I think that is going to be the mantra for success in this COVID time. We have to look at achieving sustainable growth. What is very, very important in this is that you have to grow at it has to be sustained. It is not going to be possible to have sustainable growth in the COVID era where patients are not wanting to come to you. Patients are apprehensive of coming to hospitals. So how will you be able to sustain? I think there is a challenge that is for us to actually bring back together, together with the industry, even together with all of us, we have to bring back the demand. We have to have measures which the patient would feel is going to give us safety. We are standalone eye care centers, and we don't have to be in multi-specialties where there are COVID-positive patients and there are non-COVID patients. The merging of the two is obviously going to be a fear factor. So I think if the industry and all of us come together and we accept this challenge to let patients know that adequate care is being taken for their well-being, I think all of us will prosper. There is going to be a definition of a new normal. What I feel is that the normalcy is going to change. What we thought that all of us were wanting to put up new centers or all of us were wanting to put up all the equipments in one particular place is going to change. There is going to be a definite shift where all of us are going to look at the last mile connectivity and the ease of healthcare delivery. We have never looked at the ease of the patient as to how we reach the doorsteps of the patient or how can we make healthcare delivery easy. That is what the people are looking at. And above all, what is going to happen, as you can see in every industry, the costs are going to come back. You can see that the Ayushman Bharat has reduced the cost of a cataract surgery to below 5,000 rupees. Now, is that sustainable for an individual? I don't think so. So collaboration, consolidation, and volumes, whether we go to indigenous IOLs, whether we go to indigenous phaco machines, or whether we work together to utilize the assets that we have, an asset of an operation theater, the asset of a microscope, the asset of a phaco machine, or the asset of a femto laser. These have to be put together because healthcare delivery is going to be changing, and it is going to be changing significantly. Now, what is very, very important is that for any entrepreneur or any one of us to succeed, we have to have a passion to succeed. I think there has to be the first guiding principle that we have to be passionate of what we are doing. It is not work for us, it is our passion. And above all, I think we have to also have the perseverance to deliver. Now, as I said earlier, the changing scenario needs to be adapted and adapted with a speed. A speed, for example, the speed of a fiber optic network. The digital space is booming like anything else. Have we been able to put that digital space into use in ophthalmology? I don't think so we have. So it is going to be the Amazons or the Geos, etc., which are going to come in the ophthalmic space also and use the digital connectivity, the artificial intelligence, etc., to deliver healthcare to the patient as a doorstep. So I think we as ophthalmologists need to adapt. But above all, what we have to do is that if we are adapting to this new digital era, to this new normal in healthcare that is going to be there, I think the last mile connectivity of getting the healthcare to the patient step, doorstep is going to be very, very important. How we do that, how we execute it, the speed at which we execute, and the success with which we execute is going to be very important. So friends, I think we have to be prepared at having cost curtailments, we have prepared for collaborating, we have to be prepared for consolidation, we have to take decisions which need to be taken to keep the businesses or to keep the practices alive and not stand on egos and say that I am going to have my own way and otherwise the highway. So that is not going to be there. I think if we have to succeed in these difficult times, we have to work together, we need to consolidate, and we need to shed the extra costs that we have of high-tech equipments and maybe having the foreign people coming in with selling the intraocular lens, the consumables at higher cost that is there. So finally, what I would wish to say is that if we have a mindset to change today, this tough time is not going to last forever. But I think if we toughen ourselves, to steel ourselves, to say that we have to adapt, we have to be fluid in our concept, and we have to look at the new normal, which I feel is going to be a lot of last mile connectivity with the patients, a lot of verticals coming in, which are low cost, then and then only we will succeed. So friends, let us take a tough look at these tough times, and I'm sure it is a matter of time that we will all come out of it. Even though the recession that has been there is very deep, it's a global recession. There is a significant contraction in the GDP. But I think if we formulate our guidelines, our thoughts, and we reassure the patients, and we work in a collaborative manner, I think all ophthalmologists will come out of this strong. So all the very best, and thank you very much for your kind attention. Dear friends.
Thank you, Mahipal sir. It was a wonderful, enlightening advice to the younger lot over here. But we have a lot of questions which we will be asking you at the end of the section 6. We will expect you to hold back for us for a while. Just hold back with us.
I think you, Prashant, you finished the questions now only because I know that sir is in another webinar. He's come from there. So announce the winners and then ask your questions.
Announce, sir. Dadia, sir, you announce the winners.
So, the winners of the section 5 are in the category of below 40, Dr. Chetan Dedia from Mumbai, and in the category of above 40, Dr. Anu Selvi T from Thanjavan. So congratulations to both.
Sir, before I start this next section, there are lot many things which we want to ask you. You have been like a role model to most of the ophthalmologists or many young people over here who are watching our quiz today. You are a AIOS president. You have been president of DOS, 100 plus hospitals. An insatiable appetite for you. What is your next destination?
Moksh.
No, sir. You cannot attain a moksh till you have it 1K hospitals, I believe. The type of a personality which I have witnessed in you, I'm sure you will never go to moksh or accept moksh before you have 1K hospitals under the belt of CFS.
I don't think I have a specific target or a goal as regards the number of hospitals or anything like that. I think main idea is to create an institution, a legacy, and to have something that is much bigger than you, something that survives, something that is known as a gold standard for delivery of eye care in this part of the world. So that is the constant endeavor, and I think it is a long haul. It is not something that's going to come very easy, and I think the important thing that we have done is to create a very big team right from the beginning, and that has been the essence that I feel that you create teams and the teams create the business. So that is where I am coming from. I think in the private setup, we want to be known as the gold standard in this part of the world. So that is the idea. It's not necessarily going to be counted by the number of centers or whatever it is. And obviously, I don't like failures, and one of my failures which are still there and which I want to overcome is to be a public company to have a successful IPO.
Sir, now the next question is, I won't ask you much more. I know your key to success now, you have already elaborated much. My wife is so unhappy with my single hospital being so occupied. You have 100 plus hospitals. How do you keep ma'am happy?
First of all, I don't have 100. Thank you very much. Aapke muh mein ghee shakkar. I am still, I closed down some and I am at 44. So in any case, I think happiness is something that you have to feel from within. It's something that I will say that you need to be possessed. You need to be passionate, and you need to above all have certain principles on which you work. And I think I don't believe in any shortcuts. Now, obviously, there is something called as work-life balance, especially the youngsters talk about it. But I have a lot of work colleagues. I think Namrata is one of that. Subhash also. They are people who work. The elixir for them to keep going is work. And that's what is for me, that if I am not doing work, I feel dissatisfied and kind of so... restlessness is inherent in some personalities, and that's what's there. That I still remember I had gone for a fellowship at Georgetown University 89-90, and Professor Dwight Kavanaugh, when he was giving me a farewell dinner, he said to his wife that I am myself somebody very restless, and if I have seen somebody more restless than me, it's Maipal. And if he thinks of an idea today, it should have been implemented yesterday. So that's the kind of situation which one has to, you have to tirelessly keep on working on a particular goal. But above all that I have to say is that if you are honest, truthful, and you are sincere in your work, then you will get to where you want. One thing that I want to tell a lot of young people is that nothing comes overnight. There is no overnight success. We do have stories of unicorn, etc., but that's one in a thousand, one in a million brilliant idea that somebody has. But in case you are in a delivery service where you are in ophthalmology, it is going to be a long haul. And it has to be something which is constant, and you have to take certain risks. And the risks have to be actually guided by strong fundamentals. For example, if I have to put the success of myself or Centrofusite, I'll put it on two things. One is phacoemulsification and other is the refractive surgery. We were the first movers there. And despite strong criticism of phacoemulsification at that particular time when we started in 19, actually I had just come back from Georgetown and we started in 90, the seniors were dead against phacoemulsification. They said it's a dangerous tool in the eye. You get wound burns, you get iris chafing, you iris drop, and these things never happened. But then if you have a gut feel and you feel strongly about a particular thing which is based by scientific logic, that's what you have to actually take on and push. And then it was again, despite strong resistance from my family, leaving All India Institute of Medical Sciences at an age of 38, I may have become Professor Atul and Ramanjeet, whom you have heard today. They were all contemporaries as regards becoming faculty. But I think you have to take a decision, and sometimes these decisions click, and that is what clicked. But all that I have to say is that you have to decide how to position yourself. Prashant, that is something very, very important, that you have to decide where you want to position yourself, and there is something that has to be very, very important, and that is your brand equity. Your organization should have a particular brand equity, and the positioning should be very clear in your mind. You can't be all over the place until, of course, you have to identify what are your strengths, and you have to play on your strengths. Today, if I want to go to Tamil Nadu and start, say, a rural eye care, this thing, I will not be able to do anything because I have an Arvind eye care that is going to be a competition to me or whatever it is. So I have to play to our strengths as to what your strengths are, identify your strengths. And I think your wife should be your strength rather than your weakness, because without your wife supporting you, you will never be able to succeed. And I think you have to tell her that your center or your profession is like your baby, and you care for your baby the way it is. Yes, sometimes you have to give something to get something. So family life at times does take a back seat, but I think God has been kind. Both my children are good ophthalmologists, and my wife supports me. So that's where we are.
So in a nutshell, sir, it's because of Madam's tolerance that you are growing so at such a high speed. Thank you, Michael, sir. Thank you.
We are a witness to it, Prashant. We've seen it right from our PG days, so we know it all.
Yeah, so the credit does not go to Dr. Mahipal Shastdev, I think so. You better, now we need credit to understand that.
Credit goes to both of them.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you for being with us. Now let's move with the quiz. The last Thank section you. Is left. That is section 6. And here I am with the section 6. Yes. Can you see these characters from Bond movies? People of my contemporary age, Bond movie was a craze in those days. Yes, she is Judi Dench. We popularly remember her as Miss M. This guy, Roger Moore, whom we know as only as remember as James Bond. While this lady is remembered as Moneypenny, do you know who she is? She's Naomi. And this guy, yes, he played the role of character Q in Bond movies for 17 Bond movies. Do you remember his name? Yes? No? Yes, he's Desmond. So the question for you now is, which character from the Bonds movie is almost blind due to severe AMD, that is age-related macular degeneration? Time starts now. Thank you. And here is your answer. It's Judy Dench, who has severe age-related macular degeneration, which has crippled her life to a lot of extent. But yes, no one can forget her for her fame as an M in GoldenEye movie of James Bond. Now moving on to the next question. The true statement about familial exudative vitreoretinopathy, also known as FEVR, includes all except option A, autosomal recessive disorder, option B, fundus appearance similar to patients with retinopathy of prematurity or also known as ROP, option C, peripheral retinal neovascularization is a common feature, option D, visual loss usually in early childhood. And your time starts now. So which statement about FEVR is not wrong? And the correct answer is option A. It's not an autosomal recessive disorder. In fact, it is an autosomal dominant or an X-linked disorder where we have a peripheral retinal vascularization with exudation over here, and it almost simulates a retinopathy of prematurity. And the treatment options are cryotherapies, buccal if there is a detachment, and vitrectomy if there is a hemorrhage. So coming to the next question in this session, that is, you remember this fundus with a metallic sheen? Yes, that is an Ogochi's disease. So one of the character is not there in an Ogochi's disease. Option A, it's an autosomal recessive condition. Option B, it is characterized by progressive night blindness. Option C, it has normal visual acuity and normal color vision. And option D, it is characterized by a special Mizu Nakamura phenomenon. And your time starts now. So this is Ogochi's disease with a metallic sheen. Always remember this. And only one thing of the one of the options does not fit into Ogochi's disease. And your answer is, it is not characterized by, so option B is wrong, that is characterized by progressive night blindness. It is in fact a stationary type of a night blindness. And remember this, this is a lysed exposed fundus where you get a classic metallic sheen, which is characteristic or diagnostic of a Ogochi's disease. Now coming to the next question, that is MCQ 29. CRAO and ophthalmic artery occlusion are devastating retinal condition with almost similar clinical feature. Which one of this sign favors central retinal artery occlusion? Option A, presence of cherry red spot. Option B, presence of relative afferent pupillary defect, also called REPD. Option C, reduction of both A and B waves on ERG. And option D, absence of pigmentary changes in the posterior segment. Your time starts now. And the correct answer is absence of pigmentary changes in the posterior segment. So remember, both CRAO as well as ophthalmic artery gives a classic cherry red spot in acute phases, both cause REPD. But in ophthalmic artery occlusion, there is a disturbed RP, there is pigmentary changes, which is not seen in cases of central retinal artery occlusion because it does not, if you remember, the superficial retinal circulation does not supply the outer retinal layers. And so this is the differentiation over here, which you must remember, it is available in any classic textbooks. So coming to the last question of this today's quiz session. You see these two white lesions on the fundus? Can you guess what this condition is? Probably you guessed the right diagnosis, but your question is, this fundus has three systemic associations of the four. Identify which one is not. So the question says, systemic association with the figure shown includes all except. And so the correct answer is hemicerebral atrophy with calcification. So picture shows two astrocytic hamartomas seen isolated or in tuberous sclerosis or neurofibromatosis. Remember, hemicerebral atrophy with calcification is seen in Sturge-Weber syndrome and not in astrocytic hamartoma. So coming to the end of it, so meanwhile, till our team computes the session winners, here is one more commercial break for you. This is a small video from Microlabs who are supporting our team. So by the time our back team computes the result, here is a small chat with the legends who were today present with us or who were as an invited guest. Welcome, Dr. Ashok Grover, sir. Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir. We missed you. Here you are. We have played your video, which was guiding about how to go ahead with post-PG residency, what should be done and not. Everyone appreciated it. There are a few questions which are just as routine casual chat with you.
Looking forward to the interaction.
Yeah. No, this is not a questions from the, the people who viewed it. It is from us. We have certain questions for sir, you have been a president of All India Ophthalmological Society. You have been a president of Ophthalmic Oculoplasty Association of India and whatnot. So what is your next natural destination, sir?
Tough question. Well, joy of working, that is what is most important. So I'm really looking forward to enjoying my work, enjoying my interaction with the various fora. I mean, I am still a very active member with the International Societies, International Council of Ophthalmology, Asia Pacific Academy of Ophthalmology, and I'm very interested in ophthalmic education. So I'm looking forward to working on those lines with the international agencies, trying to see that can contribute as much as I can to those causes. Also, my interest in oculoplastics, so as a South president of the South Asian Association, I'm trying to increase the oculoplastic levels across the region in the SAARC countries. So those are some of the goals that I have in mind.
Sir, you have blessed with such a soft, humble smile. Whenever I look at you, it really makes me feel very elated right from my bottom of heart. I just had a question. Did you ever get angry over certain issue ever in your life?
Best is to ask my wife.
I know. She would say I would never have got such a wonderful husband who never scolds me.
No, it's good to try and be equanimous and not have anger. But there are times you need to have genuine anger, and there are times when you need to have an artificial anger. As an administrator, sometimes you need an artificial anger. And at times you need genuine anger for some causes that you believe in. Unless you have that fire, unless you have that genuine feeling of unhappiness at certain things, you would never fight to get rid of them. So I think those are the moments where an anger is really needed from within.
I just can't accept it. You can never get angry. But still, next time when I meet a ma'am, I'm going to definitely ask, could you at least ever get this man angry? So now coming to Vishal. Vishal, are you there? Okay. Hello. Okay, Dr. Vishal is not with us. So I think till our questions are yet to be, our computation is yet to be over. Last question for Grover, sir. Sir, how do you look this ophthalmology in present context, and what do you see the future, especially for the younger people? You have been doing a lot of work for this young people regarding their education policies. You have been trying helping us out AIOS, ICO, and multiple things. Do you really feel what would be the status of our ophthalmology residents who pass out from our country if we compare it with the Western world? And what would you guide them to, how to make them equivalent or whatever you can? In a short nutshell, I know it's a very difficult question to answer.
I'm very, very positive about the future of ophthalmology in the country. I think we have one of the best run societies as the National Society, which has contributed a lot. And we have very bright youngsters. They are much, much brighter than us. They have a much better set of knowledge. I think the education of residency has improved a lot, although there is a lot more to be achieved in that field. So if the training improves, if we all strive to give them the best possible, equivalence is not the word. I think we should be far, far ahead of many others because of the advantages that we've had. We started subspecialties much earlier. We have some of the very best institutions in the world in the field of ophthalmic training. And in terms of the advantage of surgical volumes that we have, we are much better trained surgeons. Many of us have dexterity, which would be the envy of anyone in the world. So we are definitely in line to be a leader in ophthalmology, which we already are in some ways. And we must go on to take that advantage further and be a world beater. So that's what the next generation has to aim for and go for it. The sky is the limit for them. I have all the hope in the future of ophthalmology in this country.
Okay. Meanwhile, we will continue with the chat. Let me declare the session winners of section 6 winner. So less than 40 years, Dr. Vanshaj Rai from Narsingpur, MP. And section 6 winner above the age of 40 is Dr. Rajesh Garg from Yamuna Nagar, Haryana, India. Congratulations to the section winner. And now we have the final winner, that is the whole session winner, runner-up for the people above category above the age of 40 years, Dr. Sendam Mizan Reni from Pondicherry. And the winner of above 40 category is Dr. Thanika Chalam S. from Puducherry. Congratulations to you people. And runner-up from the category less than 40 years is Dr. Muthukrishnan from Chennai. And the winner is Dr. Prabhav Puri from New Delhi. Congratulations, winners. You are requested to join us on the Zoom platform. You might have been given you would be receiving the link in a short while. Do join us for the concluding ceremony where you will be felicitated with your gift vouchers, as well as you will be getting an opportunity to interact with the top legends of our country. So by the time these people join us, we will continue with your chat for a while. And now coming to the co-host of mine, Dr. Namrata Sharma.
Yeah.
Secretary, Delhi Ophthalmological Society. Secretary, All India Ophthalmological Society. And I don't know. It's a line, ...
Where join us.
Continue with your chat for a while. And now coming to the co-host of mine, Dr. Namrata Sharma, Secretary of Ophthalmological Society, Secretary of All India Ophthalmological Society, and I don't know, the line ... And now coming to the co-host of mine.
Sushant is echoing. Admin, can you take care of this, please? Yeah. It is echoing at several places.
Yeah, now we can hear you.
Yes.
So you got my question. So there are so many commas, DOS secretary, AIO secretary. When will we get a full stop?
At what point? Admin.
Sai, we need your help. What is happening?
I think
we shall request the winners to just keep their mic muted, please, when they join in. Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Yeah. No. So, Prashant, there is no end to doing work. I personally believe you don't need if you want to work, work is something like even Dr. Mahipal said. You can say I'm a workaholic, and I actually do not do anything except for ophthalmology. That is the only thing that I do, and that has been there for last almost 30 years now, into 365 days. Earlier, we used to take a break for 3-4 days in a year. Even that has stopped now. So it's like that, and I think it is the way you. It's all in your. If I don't work, I feel I feel guilty about it, or I feel if I slow down on my pace, I feel that why has my pace slowed down? I mean, I feel guilty about it. So there is a rhythm, there is a speed at which one works, and you just want to continue doing that only.
Madam, you skirted away from the main issue. I asked you, Secretary DOS, Secretary AOS, where would that full stop come? So please directly answer. Please do not beat around the bush.
Full stop will come as the tenures are getting over. All of them will full stop one day. But like I said, it does not matter. Whether you are, the power is in the person and not in the chair. So it does not matter where you are sitting. It does not matter at what post you are. If you are at a particular post, it is just an opportunity for you to perform at that post better. But even if you don't have it, you would still do it. I mean, if you have to do it. So that's what I feel. The power is within you. And these are just, what do you say, milestones which one covers, just finishes them off to reach at the last destination.
So you are not going to define where is the end point of your...
I myself don't know.
Okay. Madam, you have been an icon for so many female ophthalmologists. People really look up to you. All these girls, I have so many female colleagues of mine who look up to you as a role model. How does it feel to be a role model? Don't you feel weighed by the expectations which people have from you?
I feel weighed by the expectations that I have from myself. So I think sometimes you are very harsh on yourself, and you want to do, sometimes you don't even get sleep, because your mind is so active. It's forever thinking. It just doesn't stop. So it is like that. So I think it's just an attitude, and you just live with it.
Okay. Thank you, madam. And now to the DOS president, Dr. Subhash Dadia. Sir, are you there? Subhash, sir. Dadia, sir. Hello. Hello. Sai, is Dr. Dadia there?
Ji, sir.
Sir, aap ek chote se gaon se Haryana se RP center pahunche. RP center se aap nikle, Maulana Azad aaye, professor, aap Strabismological Society. A dream walk. Dream walk, and it was not a cake walk for you. A person from a small village making a mark at Delhi, making a such a big, being a president of DOS now. कैसा लगता है?
It is destiny.
Sir, destiny तो नहीं होता है सर, destiny
तो destiny and hard work. Destiny and hard work.
तो आपने कभी सोचा था सर, जब आप 10th 12th में थे या जैसे MBBS स्टूडेंट थे आप, क्योंकि आज कैसा है कि there are many young people who are looking at us. So we need कि ऐसा क्या था आप में कि जो आपने अपने आप में देखा और आपको लगा कि नहीं, मैं एक दिन डॉस का प्रेसिडेंट बन के दिखाऊंगा, मैं आरपी सेंटर से एमडी करके दिखाऊंगा.
बेसिकली आई हैव बीन वर्किंग फॉर द पीपल्स ड्यूरिंग सेक्रेटरीशिप ऑफ स्टूडेंट यूनियन आर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ आरडीए आर प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ फैकल्टी एसोसिएशन आर सेक्रेटरी ऑफ स्टारबिस्मोलॉजिकल सोसाइटी ऑफ इंडिया सेक्रेटरी डोस आर सेक्रेटरी सार्क सोसाइटी ऑफ स्टारबिस्मस एंड पेडियाट्रिक ऑप्थाल्मोलॉजी आई हैव बीन वर्किंग फॉर द पीपल्स एंड इट इज लव एंड अफेक्शन ऑफ द पीपल्स.
सर, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ स्टूडेंट यूनियन वगैरह थोड़े से मसल वगैरह तो होने मांगते हैं आपके जैसे.
No. His muscle is in his brain. You don't realize that, Prashant.
I'm just pulling
it. The muscle is here. Muscle is here.
He's like a younger brother. I have the right to pull him.
Yeah, you can. I have seen Dr. Subhash, working relentlessly, helping people everywhere where he's gone, whether it's student union or it is, I remember him as an RDA president, our own resident, postgraduates. I know GNEC PGs, they vouch by him, because he really helps everybody.
That's so nice of him.
He helps everyone.
That's what I really appreciate about this gentle human being over there, who's now adorning the post of president of Delhi Ophthalmological Society. So young guys, remember, you might be from a small village background, or you can be from one of the elitist schools of Delhi or whatever be. Anyone can make it to the topmost post. You have to love people, you have to work for them, and you have to be selfless. This is the mool mantra in coming into the societies and making a mark. It does not need your destiny. It does not need your background, what you are, which place you are. Anyone can make into the top post. And I'm sure that is why we have so many inspiring people today as a guest and an invited faculty as well as my co-host today. So now I think we are ready with our tabulated results. I think most of the people who have won the award, section winners and the session winners, have joined us on the chat. So let us begin the concluding ceremony of ours. Can we have screen sharing? We start the screen sharing. Concluding ceremony will be.
So I think we have to felicitate our winners.
Yeah.
And the winners.
Yeah. Abhisai
Popat. For the mega quiz, I would request for section one.
We have to start with section winners, madam.
Yeah.
You keep on announcing.
I'll keep on announcing.
And we can ask them one question, interact with them one question.
So for section one, which was on cornea and refractive, the winner is Dr. Sevagami from Puducherry, Guru Murthy from Protatur. Do we have both of them? Yes, Dr. Guru Murthy is there. And Dr. Sevagami, congratulations. Many congratulations. And I would request Dadia and Dr. Bhalla both to be here, to be interacting with them. Dr. Bhalla.
Bhalla sahab, ek question pooch sakte hai aap.
Unmute yourself. Sevagami, you are from which place? You are from, we know, from Puducherry. What are you doing right now?
I'm doing my secondary DNB at Indira Gandhi Medical
College. Wow, excellent. At such a young age, you've been able to crack it. Dr. Bhalla?
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, it's really very creditable, Dr. Sevagami. You still not completed your DNB and you have won this prestigious...
Stop sharing the screen, please. Sai, your screen is sharing. Yes.
Yeah. Heartiest congratulations to you on behalf of Delhi Ophthalmological Society, and Dr. Prashant, you have been a wonderful host. It's really a pleasure to listen to you, the way you have conducted along with Dr. Namrata and Dr. Subhash.
We have been tutored by him. He was the one who's doing the show.
No, Allah sir, now is not the time for basically the people who have worked and won the prizes for us. We need to interact with each one winner. Ask a question, something like that, and we need few encouraging word, guidance, whatever you want to put there.
Yeah, I think it's congratulations.
Sevagami, what do you want to do after you do your DNB? Which subject interests you? Cornea. I am sitting here, and you've won in cornea.
Yes, ma'am. Definitely, I am more interested in cornea.
Okay. I'm sitting there.
Sevagami, that is unfair. Retina quiz master, you are not impressed by him. Just pulling. Okay. The next participant. Next.
But you cannot do cornea without binocularity.
Dr. Guru Murthy, nice to have you here. And you are from Protatur. Which institution are you in? Or which?
Sir, you unmute yourself.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear you, Dr. Guru Murthy. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Dr. Guru Murthy. I'm a senior ophthalmic surgeon in Puducherry. I'm a private practitioner.
So what's your age?
Let me ask.
Huh? Okay. He's more than 40, that is good enough.
So how can you be as fast as a kid who are less than 40? You were as fast as it. The way you answered, seriously, it is giving me complex to my gray cells. I'm feeling I am getting Alzheimer's, the way you responded fast.
Thank you very much, sir.
It's congratulations.
He is young. Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Gurumukhi. Thank you so much. If we come to Product Tour, we'll definitely come and meet you.
Thank you. I'm welcome to.
Do we show the certificates now? Or?
Yeah. Now only, madam. Now.
So, Sai, can you show the certificate for our winners of Section 1, Dr. Sivagami from Puducherry and Dr. Gurumurthy from Product Tour?
Congratulations. Next, Section 1.
And Dr. Gatur.
The certificates are arranged in the order of the top 40, all the less than 40 in one shot and greater than 40 in the other shot, madam.
Okay.
Take care. Then we go like that.
So we have winners of Section 2 now. Winners of Section 2 is Dr. Maria Doctor from Hyderabad in less than 40 years and Dr. Rupa from Mumbai. So we first go to Dr. Rupa from Mumbai. Has she joined as a panel? Yes. How are you? You are, can you please introduce yourself, Dr. Rupa?
Yes, ma'am. Right now I'm not in Mumbai, I'm in Chennai with my in-laws. So I'm in Chennai. No, I'm not exactly in Mumbai. I used to work for Inlax Hospital in Mumbai. I was a private practitioner there. Yeah.
Okay.
So I have special interest in medical retina as well.
Medical, Prashant, that's for you. Medical retina.
Dr. Rupa. Dr. Rupa.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
You have won the prize in category more than 40 years. Tell me the real reason you eat almonds or what to increase your speed of the brain, the way it works as a microprocessor.
Sir, right now from last 6 months, I guess, since the corona, it's only home food cooked by me and my mother-in-law.
No, but how
yeah,
come
that's...
we as a practitioners are really out of touch. The way you answered speedily, it speaks about the way you keep abreast your knowledge. So, congratulations once more from our team.
Thank you so much, sir. I'm really privileged and honored with this award. Even it's a surprise for me. I didn't guess, actually. My kids were playing around. I was just to kill time, I thought I'll just enroll and do it just to keep abreast of my knowledge. And I have won it. And it gives me great pleasure. And now my interest has, deepened now. I'll be participating more and more now. So thanks to you for your organizing such an amazing quiz for people above 40 who have stopped. I mean, we actually don't touch textbooks right now. We think that, our practical knowledge is enough. But this keeps us, going into the basics of the topics. So that is really interesting. Thank you so much for organizing the quiz. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Dr. Balla sahab, dekhiye, jo log bahar practice mein, un log bhi padhte hain. कुछ आपके कमेंट इनके बारे में क्या सोचते हो आप डॉक्टर रूपा के बारे में
नहीं नहीं सर वो भी बहुत पढ़ते हैं सर डॉक्टर प्रशांत यू आर ए रोल मॉडल फॉर सो मेनी ऑफ ऑल ऑफ अस सर यू कैन टीच एनीथिंग फ्रॉम रेटिना एनी टाइम टू एनी ऑल ऑफ अस सर
वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डॉक्टर रूपा
आई थिंक यू ओज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ सक्सेस टू योर इन-लॉज आल्सो बिकॉज़ आई थिंक इन-लॉज हैव बीन वेरी लकी फॉर यू ऑन द प्राइज इन चेन्नई नॉट इन मुंबई
I'm honored to be with my in-laws, definitely. It's a privilege to be as a joint family. It's a great thing, actually.
Yeah.
Dr. Maria Doctor is there in age group less than 40. Has she joined? Yes, she has joined. Dr. Maria?
Yes, hello.
Hello, Dr. Maria. We can't see your video. Yeah. Can you introduce yourself? Yes, Maria.
I'm doing my primary DND from LD Prasad Eye Hospital, Hyderabad.
Perfect, perfect. So you're right now in Hyderabad.
So it's the first year residency or second year or third year, Dr. Maria?
No, I'm in my final year currently. Yeah, I'm in my final year currently.
Okay, okay.
What do you want to take after you finish your DNB?
Either cornea or cataract refractive.
Okay, cataract. So she is with me. So don't worry, Prashant. Sorry about it.
No, but the thing is, LVP means only cornea. That's the thing, my Dr. Maria. That is what you mean?
No, I mean, she doesn't.
All people from LVP start speaking only about cornea.
No. She doesn't mean that at all. And see, she won a quiz in section 2. So section 2 was Dr. Daria's section.
Migration of AMM.
Nice meeting you, Rupa. Congratulations. Can we see her certificate?
Sai, can you display the certificate, please?
Okay, maybe we can display all of them together in the end.
Yeah. Okay.
So winner of section 3 and section 3 was Prashant's section. More than 40 years is Dr. Santosh Kumar from Delhi. Dr. Santosh has joined.
Yeah, he has joined.
Dr. Santosh is joined.
He was there.
Yeah. Yes, he's there. So Dr. Santosh, can you please introduce yourself?
Ma'am, I already know you very well for the rest of our time. I'm Colonel Santosh. I left Army 2 years back after having served for 25 years. And currently I've relocated to Hyderabad. And I'm a professor in MR Medical College. And I thank the organizers to keep us active on this lazy Sunday afternoon. And I think it's a great learning. It gives me great pleasure to be back into DOS again and again.
Thank you.
And I take this opportunity just to tell the postgraduates to grab this opportunity, because we really have less of clinical load now in this COVID era. And thank you once again for the encouragement. Thank you.
Sir, you are always part of DOS.
Definitely.
He is always a part of, a very integral part of DOS and always been there. We have very fond memories of him when he was at RP Center. And also at RR or at Base Hospital. I think RR. I remember visiting several times. Yes.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Dr. Santosh Kumar, sir, you are a teacher. In fact, our qualifying rules had forgot to mention that the teaching faculties should not be eligible for this. You know, you give us a complex. See, looking at you, you are giving a complex to us that we are really ill-rate.
No.
Congratulations, anyway. Thank you.
Somebody sharing the screen? No.
Madam Padhi sir, Shrikant Padhi se aapne interact nahi kiya.
Shrikant Padhi se maine isliye interact nahi kiya because Shrikant Padhi is very close to me. He's been my student. Padhi, how are you? He's right now in Bhubaneswar, I know that. And he's pursuing
him.
Padhi, I think you introduce yourself.
Hello, ma'am. I'm Dr. Shrikant Kumar Padhi. I did my MD degree from RP Center AIIMS. Currently, I'm working as clinical adjunct in retina and vitreous services, LV Prasada Institute.
Shrikant, Dr. Yes. Santosh, the nation wants to know that both of you are from RP Center and madam was the quiz master.
Yes.
Is there any link?
No, sir.
No, there is another link, which does not say his better half is posted with us as a senior resident.
Oh, really? So exactly,
there is no link. I'm proud of him that he's not done it in my section, he's done it in your section.
Okay, congratulations Dr. Padhi, we are very proud of you.
Thank you.
And again, a retina guy, it makes me more happier. So now section 4 winner, madam.
Section 4 winner is more than 40 years, Dr. Pranav Ranjan is there. Dr. Pranav Ranjan has joined. No, I think he's not joined. He's from Patna. We all know him very well, Dr. Pranav Ranjan. And Dr. Rinki Saha has joined in less than 40 years. I think she also not joined.
Not joined?
So Rinki, I don't see that she has
joined. No, she has not joined.
Okay.
So then winners of the section 5 are Dr. Chintan Dedia.
He has joined.
So Dr. Chintan.
Hello, madam. Good evening, madam. Good evening
to all. I know you very well. You introduced to everyone else.
So I am Chintan Dedia. I'm a practicing VR surgeon in Mumbai. Did my fellowship from Elvi Prasad Eye Institute, Hyderabad, retina fellowship. And one more ICO fellowship in medical retina from Jules Stein Eye Institute, UCLA, California.
Chintan, you are a retina surgeon. Or ye kya neuro-ophthalm mein aap kaise kya crack kar rahe ho? Ya retina mein peeche rahe ke?
That's my passion, actually. Neuro-ophthalm is my passion. Like, retina and neuro-ophthalm both I practice.
We disown you now as a retina surgeon. VRS, I will disown you now.
No. We are proud of you, Chintan, that despite being a retina person, you've been able to answer neuro-ophthalmology questions. Good. Great. Keep it up.
Yeah. So thanks, Brain Teasers team and all the esteemed panel and the legends and also the Microvision for organizing this quiz. Like, apart from winning is one thing, but participating is in quiz is the biggest fun, whether you win or lose. And a lot of things to learn also. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Chintan.
Okay. Congratulations.
Yeah. Congratulations. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Congratulations. And in more than 40 years, we have Dr. Ambu Selvi T from Thanjavur. So, Ambu Selvi, welcome again. What are you doing?
Madam, thank you. Thank you all, eminent ophthalmologists of this time, whole nation. I'm very, very happy to be here. And I'm an associate professor of ophthalmology attached to a government medical college in my place. And at this time, my sincere thanks and congratulations to Dr. Prashant. And I have been, a sincere follower of this Brain Teasers quiz since it was started last year. Like every Sunday, we used to be waiting for the session and attending the quiz, and everything was more of a fun and knowledge. My sincere thanks and congrats to the entire team and giving me this opportunity to be here. Thank you, madam, and thank you, sir, and all of you.
Thank you, Dr. Ambu Selvi, for your kind words. But really, looking at you people above the age of 40 category still makes me hopeful that one day I would be as learned as you. Congratulations, mm-hmm. Once more.
Thank you.
Then we come to section 6. The winner in more than 40 years category is Dr. Rajesh Garg. He's from Yamunanagar, Haryana. I know him very well, Dr. Rajesh. Would you please introduce yourself? Dr. Rajesh, we are missing on your video. Yes.
Yes.
Perfect.
Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, everybody. It was a nice seeing the playing the quiz and interacting with you all, and learned quite a lot from your quiz.
Thank you. Thank you for joining the quiz, and thank you for joining the panel. And many congratulations to you.
Thank you, ma'am.
In less than 40 years category, we have Dr. Vanshaj Rai from Narsingpur. Dr. Vanshaj Rai has joined. I don't see the name on the panel, so.
He's joined.
I think he's joined, Vanshaj Rai.
Hello, good evening, sir. Good evening to all esteemed quiz master, okay. Sir.
Good evening.
Good evening. Hello, good evening. Esteemed quiz master.
Unmute yourself.
Please introduce yourself, Vanshaj.
Ma'am, I am doing a residency in Arvind Eye Hospital, Pondicherry currently, and I am secondary DNB president.
Okay, good. At secondary resident level DNB, you've been able to crack it. So very good, excellent, and that too in neuro ophtha section. Many congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
So many congratulations to you, Vanshaj.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank
you. Now coming to the session winners, ma'am, sir, both of you can declare first the runner-up and then the winner.
I think Dr. Subhash, you do this. Do these honors.
Dadia, sir. Yeah.
So first the runner-up in more than 40 years. I think we can see him here. Subhash. Is there?
Hello? Yes, ma'am.
So can... the runner up in the runner up in more than 40 years category is Dr. Sandramizhan Reni from Pondicherry. Many congratulations to you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Could you please introduce yourself?
I'm Dr. Sandramizhan Reni, working as specialist in ophthalmology in Government General Hospital, Pondicherry, madam. I was the runner-up in the brain teasers season one also for the age group above 40.
So, Dr. Sharp, you need to give a special prize to Dr. Rene. He's been runner-up in two seasons. That's a big, big achievement.
Yeah. And Subhash is there. Subhash, will you announce the winner in more than 40 years category? I don't think we have him here on the panel, but I know him very well. And so does Subhash. He's a great friend of, you know, both of us.
I think you can announce. Meanwhile, sir can interact.
Okay. So it is Dr. Tanika Chalam from Pondicherry. He is known to both of us. Tanika
yeah.
Chalam. Is he there, Dr. Tanika Chalam?
Yes, not joined.
He's not joined. But yes, he's from RP Center. He was my junior. And I think Subhash also knows him very well.
He's very sincere. He was very sincere. Very sincere.
Very hardworking at that time, I'm sure. And now less than 40 years. Subhash, would you want to announce less than
40 you can years? Announce. You can announce.
So less than 40 years runner-up category is, I think there is a mistake here because the winner less than 40 and more than 40, I think Sai, you've interchanged because I know, okay, less than 40 years, the runner-up is Dr. Muthu Krishnan from Chennai. Dr. Muthu Krishnan is there.
And he gets a gift voucher of 10,000 rupees.
Okay. I think he's not there. And there's only one person who's sitting here and whose name has not been taken. And I'm extremely, extremely proud because that person is again from RP Center, Dr. Prabhav Puri, winner up in the category of less than 40 years.
Grover, sir, if he's there, he can interact with him, ask him a few questions, really quizzing. Winner should be quizzed. Grover, sir?
I think Grover, sir, is not there.
Okay.
Dr. Balla is there.
Balla, sir, please.
Yeah.
Quizzing karo, itne hoshyar log hai apne saath. अपना भी नॉलेज बढ़ेगा
डॉक्टर प्रभाव सो व्हाट डू यू प्लान टू डू व्हाट आर यू डूइंग राइट नाउ वेयर आर यू वर्किंग
सर आई हैव जस्ट नाउ पास्ड माय एमडी एग्जामिनेशन फ्रॉम आरपीसी एम्स सो अभी सर जस्ट डिसाइडिंग टू स्पेशलाइज इन व्हिच ब्रांच स्टिल कंफ्यूज्ड सर
सो यू हैव थ्री स्टॉलवर्ट्स सिटिंग हियर ऑफ स्ट्रैबिस्मस कॉर्निया एंड रेटिना
सर आई एम अंडर यस सर आई एम अंडर कांस्टेंट गाइडेंस ऑफ सर प्रोफेसर नम्रता मैम प्रोफेसर रमनजीत मैम And even Atul Kumar sir, who couldn't be with us today. So sir, with their constant guidance and support, sir, most likely will decide.
Yeah, but that's a Prabhav, that's a very diplomatic answer. If you are given a choice, cornea, retina, you have to choose one. What would you say?
Dr. Balla is going to be extremely, extremely diplomatic now because he has a senior residency exam in the next 1 week. And if he commits to anything now,
Then I won't push him. But all the best, be wonderful.
What he's going to get, according to that, he's going to decide. So,
all confusions are sorted out in Star Business.
Yes. So, Prabhav is not going to commit anything right now because his future will be decided after 1 week when he gives the exam of senior residency.
All the best, Prabhav. Congratulations.
I would like to thank the entire faculty of RPC, sir. Sir, the best teaching is there, sir.
Definitely. No doubt about that.
Prabhav, आपका इंटरव्यू है ये बात सही है पर ये प्लेटफॉर्म अलग है यू डोंट नीड टू यू शुड से यू विल लाइक टू बिकम ए वीआर सर्जन लाइक मी और ए ग्लॉकोमा सर्जन लाइक डॉक्टर भल्ला बोलो यार कुछ नहीं होगा
no,
no, you can say I will forgive you Prabhav you can say you want to become a virtual
today is your day you should not be afraid even of your professor yes. Dr. Namrata Sharma
you should follow your passion it doesn't yes. mean it doesn't make a difference you know who's sitting in front of you what you like you should do
thank you okay. so much ma'am thank you so much ma'am.
Okay so you've had a great day Sai can you just share your screen and put up all the certificates one by one so that we all can see it thank you everybody for being here thank you Prashant I think we really need to thank you
yeah.
and we need to thank Sai for Numerotech for you know coming out with this very innovative platform it's not easy to do it so Sai you can go one by one so many congratulations to the winners Dr. Srikant Padi section winner category 1 Rinki Saha section winner again category 1 that is doctors below 40 years Chintan Deria section winner Dr. Vanshaj Rai section winner Dr. Guru Murthy again section winner Dr. Rupa section winner Dr. Santosh Kumar section winner Colonel Santosh Kumar Dr. Pranav Ranjan sir section winner again Dr. Ambu Selviti section winner Dr. Rajesh Garg from Haryana section winner Dr. Muthu Krishnan again a section winner and 10,000 rupees Amazon gift card voucher we would like to thank Microvision for you know coming up with this whole sponsorship which is a grant for educational purposes which has been given to DOS so thank you so much Mr. Ashok Microvision and your entire team Dr. Prabhav Puri, the winner in age group less than 40 years, 20,000 worth amazing gift cards. And many congratulations to you, Prabhav, and many congratulations to all the winners for participating in Mega Quiz, for winning it, and all those who've not won it, also congratulations and thank you for participating in it. Everybody and can we have our back end team now Mr. Ashok Mr. Pathak Mr. Sai and of course we can't thank enough thank you so much for doing this we can't thank you. Enough Prashant Bhavankule it's his brainchild brain teasers thank you so much Prashant for allowing DOS to encroach on your platform
no it's not an encroachment it is a privilege madam it is a wonderful platform And I'm really thankful to us for giving us a bigger platform for Brain Teasers. On behalf of Brain Teasers, we are really thankful to you as well as Dadia sir and the whole DOS executive.
So I would like to thank the president, Professor Subhash Dadia, who's so very, you know, encouraging and so active. I mean, for everything, he takes decisions in seconds, you know, like a lightning. And he just abides by it. I mean, that is his greatest asset. And of course, Dr. Bhalla, who's the treasurer of DOS. Subhash, would you want to say something?
Thank you, everybody.
He's a man of few words, but a man of action.
Let me also say good evening, doctors. Let me say thanks to DOS first, mainly to DOS executive members, Dr. Professor Subhash Dadia and Dr. Namrata Sharma and Dr. Bhalla and other members for giving us this opportunity to be a part of, along with Dr. Prashant Bhavankule, and Sai, the brainchild, brain teasers. And let me congratulate all the winners from Microvision and also all the participants to be with us. And we had a very good participation and we learned a lot and we enjoyed the most. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. So all the viewers, before we sign off, remember Brain Teasers will be conducted again. That is a monthly quiz which we conduct will be on the first Sunday of September. That is 6th of September between 10 to 12 a.m. So you're all welcome to participate. Keep participating, keep playing, keep learning, and keep winning more prizes. So bye-bye, good evening, and take care. Good night.
Thank you, Navneet, and thank you, Sai. Thanks a ton, Sai. It was very impressive.
Thank you, madam.
Thank very impressive, Prashant. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks to all of you.
Thank you, Navneet.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, Nambra, madam.